Hi everyone, welcome to our Concise Advice presentation. My name is Natalie Olive and I'm currently one of the peer assistants in the Career Center. This presentation is going to cover our top five resume tips, and so with that, let's get started. If you have any questions that come up throughout the presentation, feel free to send us an email at csecareer@umn.edu and we'd be happy to help. First and foremost, what is a resume? A resume is really a marketing tool that highlights your professional self. It highlights your skills, your experiences, and your accomplishments in a concise and professional way. We like to think of resumes as your ticket to getting an interview because in most cases, that is the first bit of information that an employer gets to learn about you. If they like what they see, they'll want to learn more in an interview. We will get into this more in a further slide, but something to keep in mind is that it is very important to tailor your resume according to the specific needs of an employer or job posting. So, after this presentation, if you have any more questions or want to check out some sample resumes, definitely check out our undergraduate resume guide on our website. Our first resume tip we have is to organize sections. It really depends on the person and what applies to this person, but these are some of the common resume sections you'll see on a resume. You'll want to have a heading that contains your name and contact information so that the employer knows who you are and how to contact you. Objectives are becoming much less common these days, so these are optional to have on your resume. It's definitely the first thing to go if you're short on space. You will also have an education section that contains your degree, the college you've attended, your graduation date, among other optional things, such as your GPA or relevant coursework. A skills section is very common for engineering students given the technical applications that are commonly used. However, you want to make sure that you're only listing technical skills in this section and using your skill statements to portray transferable skills. You'll want to have different types of experience, whether that be work experience, research, projects, volunteer, etc. And lastly, you may have an activities section that highlights any student groups or extracurriculars. Something to point out is that you really want to stay away from resume templates because they can be quite hard to customize and are often an incorrect format for CSE resumes. Also, some companies use applicant tracking systems which scan through resumes electronically and look for certain keywords and pieces of information. Resume templates can oftentimes confuse the applicant tracking systems if it has extra graphics or columns. So tip number two is to tailor your experiences. Something that may help with this is starting with a master resume that contains all your experiences, skills, activities, anything that you could think of that you'd possibly want on your resume. From there, you can look at the job description to determine what you should highlight on your resume for this specific job. Remember, you don't have to include everything on your resume. You just want to include what is most relevant if you can't fit everything on that one page. It is also important to choose experiences that you're confident in talking about. Expect that an interviewer may ask about anything you put on your resume, and you don't want to give the impression that you lied about something you put on your resume. Lastly, it helps to organize your resume if you create specific headings based on experience type, which also makes it easier for employers to locate certain skills. So for example, you could have a title called Work Experience, Leadership Experience, Research experience, activities, volunteer experience, etc. Our next tip is to articulate skills, which is the main goal of your resume. Within each of your experiences, you'll want to add detailed descriptions of your specific duties while also highlighting skills you use to accomplish those tasks. These skill descriptions should help highlight any key projects or accomplishments. And it is a good idea to quantify the impact of your work if possible. Throughout these descriptions, you'll want to include technical and transferable skills to show that you can do the technical work while also having the soft skills to support that. However, you want your descriptions to demonstrate or prove these transferable skills without directly stating them. In order to describe our experiences, we use skill statements. Skill statements have the format of action verb plus details plus outcome or results. It is best to start your skill statements with a strong action verb, and you'll want to avoid repetition and vague words like worked, taught, or responsible for. The details will contain the situation or problem that you fulfilled, and as I mentioned before, it is important to quantify your work when possible. For example, saying you managed a classroom of 40 students says more than you managed a classroom, or saying you prepared weekly reports is stronger than saying you prepared reports. The outcome of this skill statement will explain what happened as a result of your action or how it contributed to the company and what skills and strengths that you gained. While the specific tasks are important and employers do want to know what you did, the main focus is the skills that you developed. In the undergraduate resume guide, we have a long list of strong action verbs to help you out in writing these skill statements. For example, as you see in the action verb description, it's stronger to use verbs like collaborated, implemented, or developed to show more about what it was that you did. Tip number 4 is to pay attention to formatting. Proper formatting is crucial to a good first impression of your resume because this is normally the first thing that catches the reader's eye when they look at your resume. It should be clear and easy to read with proper spacing, font style, and font size. You want to keep it simple and consistent by using the same formatting across sections. Ensure that important information isn't getting lost in the body of a text that is hard to skim. For undergraduate resumes, be sure that you keep it to one page and one page only, because employers only spend about 6 to 10 seconds looking at your resume, so you want to be sure they're not skipping over information. This is where tailoring your resume comes into play. As I mentioned, employers spend very little time looking at each resume, so this is why formatting is so important. Poor formatting will oftentimes distract the reader from the quality of the content, so you want to make sure this isn't the case. Our fifth and final tip is to proofread. Given that your resume is a professional document, you want to make sure there are no errors in terms of misspelled words or poor grammar. Always proofread and have one or two other people review your resume as well to get a different set of eyes. After all the work you've put into creating your resume, it would be a huge bummer not to get a job because of a bad first impression due to spelling and grammar mistakes, which can easily be avoided. So that wraps up our top 5 resume tips. For further information on any career-related topics, there are a variety of places you can go. We do have our spring career fair coming up in February, which will also be virtual as it was in the fall. And around career fair time, we will be having our virtual workshops, virtual resume marathon, and virtual practice interview days. You can also sign up for a career counseling appointment if you have specific questions you would like to get answered at any time. But if you don't have time or need for a 30-minute appointment, you can also attend a drop-in appointment, which are Monday through Friday, 2 to 4 p.m. on Zoom. And as always, feel free to email us at csecareer@umn.edu with any questions you may have. If you haven't already, check out GoalPass, which is our job and internship search database, and we also have many career guides on our website that contain a ton of helpful information. So with that, thank you for listening to our presentation on our top 5 resume tips, and I hope you learned a thing or two that will improve your resume.